Ramadan Juma is calling passengers into a bus, popularly known by locals as Dala Dala, riding in the busy city of Dar es Salaam. Neither the driver nor his passengers are wearing masks to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Juma says lack of clear instructions from Tanzanian authorities have led many to become less serious about the pandemic.
There's no emphasis. I cannot wear a mask because when I look at the people in the surrounding, there is no one who is wearing masks, no sanitizers, and also there are no water tanks here. In short, there is no shock for my fellows, so I cannot be shocked as my fellows. I take it the same.
A week ago, for just the second time in a year, Tanzanian authorities gave statistics for the number of COVID-19 patients in the country. They said from January through July 8th of this year, there were just over 400 COVID cases. Rates groups say numbers over the last year are likely much higher. The government says it is currently working on importing vaccines and calling for people to take preventive steps.
The government continues to ask every citizen to take precautions against COVID-19 by following the guidelines from our health experts, since prevention is better than cure.
It's a sharp turn from the position of the late President John Magufuli, who denied the presence of the virus in Tanzania and discouraged the use of face masks. Rights activists accused the government of failing to provide good information and leadership in the face of the pandemic.
The government has created a big division in the society due to the fact that society has people with different understandings.
Tanzania's health minister says the country must unite against the virus.
This outbreak of disease is like a war because it claims the lives of many and weakens the economy of the country. We must join forces, and I'm expecting to see you, with your cameras, go into public buses telling people about this information, and then you say you have participated in the war.
Meanwhile, Ramadan Juma continues with his work, despite being at high risk of contracting COVID-19. Juma says serious emphasis on prevention will make people, especially his passengers, to take precautions, something that will also make him do the same. Charles Kombe, for VOA News, in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania.